From 500 feet in the air, you can see a whole lot. One thing you can't see is a potentially deadly methane gas leak. Methane is odorless, colorless, highly flammable, and difficult to detect.
Normally, we'd have greenhouse gas analyzer, an ozone analyzer. We've also had NO2 analyzer.
Steve Conley and Ian Faluna are atmospheric scientists at UC Davis. Steve happens to also be a pilot. The two have been using this Mooney TLS airplane equipped with high-tech instruments to study how gases mix and disperse in the atmosphere. About a year ago, their work caught the eye of PG&E, who wondered, could this high-flying technology help detect a gas leak?
Well, PG&E's main objective is to ensure the safety of the public and the safety of our employees. So to that end, we're always looking for more effective ways to find and fix natural gas leaks.
When they realized that we could possibly develop a system that they could put on their planes and fly and automatically detect things, they're very excited because there's miles and miles that the old-fashioned way would be sending people out with handheld detectors and walking the whole line.
Their research will trace 600 miles of PG&E's 6,000-mile pipeline.
So this is your headset.
All right.
Conley took me up for a spin and a lesson in how they transmit data from their analyzers in real time to PG&E crews on the ground. Bigger leaks appear as spikes. The smaller ones are found only after a closer look.
What happens afterwards is we have a program that we run that analyzes the data, looks at the wind, figures out where everything was, and then gives you marks and locations of where the actual leaks were.
It's a solution that could make a big difference for gas providers everywhere, increasing efficiency and, most importantly, safety. Kristen Samos for UC Davis.